Satellite uplink design. Satellite link means what? It is the transmission path between earth station and satellite. So what in by our next question is what in by uplink, satellite uplink. So satellite uplink is nothing but the link between the earth station and satellite in upper direction. So look at this diagram. This is our diagram. Two earth station are shown here and satellite. So we are transmitting the signal from first earth station in upper direction towards the satellite. So this transmission path is this is the transmission path between first earth station and satellite. So this link is nothing but our uplink. We are transmitting the signal from earth station to satellite in upper direction. If the transmission of the signal from satellite to the other station in downward direction, that link is called as downlink. So in this topic, we are dealing with the uplink design. Before I deal with the uplink design, we have to see the fundamental equations of received power as well as the factors involved in the link. So the satellite link design includes various factors. The first factor is what? That is the transmitted power and transmitting and receiving antenna gain, losses involved in the link while transmitting the data on the link, and the noise power, noise temperature. While performing the link power budget, the following information should be known to us. That is, what are the sources of noise, power sources, and the allocation of resources for transmission as well as the reception of signals. So let us, we are going to discuss the fundamental equations required for the reception of signal. So while designing the link, there are some important issues are involved. So what are these issues? First issue is what? What is the weight of the satellite? Selection of the frequency band in which the link will operate. And the atmospheric propagation effects. Type of the antenna involved in the link and the issues related to that. So let us here, we are going to see the equation of the received power. So calculation of the power is depend upon the various factor. So power is transmitting from the source and it is received at the receiver. So here in this case, we are using a isotropic source. Isotropic source means what? The power is equally radiated in all directions. So there are two approaches to calculate the power received by the earth station from the satellite transmitter or other. So these are the two approaches. First is our use of flux density. Second is the link equation. Now look at this basic diagram here. That is, isotropic source is mentioned and the receiver is mentioned. The isotropic source is radiating the power and the at a distance r from the isotropic source, it is received at the receiver by the receiving antenna. So the area of the receiving antenna is A and gain of the receiving antenna is GR. So here is a EIRP is mentioned. EIRP means what? Equivalent isotropic radiated power. It is equal to P. So these are the fundamental equations required to get the received power at the satellite receiver or earth station receiver. So first equation is the incident flux density is nothing but Pt upon 4 pi r square. Received power is Pr is equal to F into A. So received power is nothing but product of the EIRP into gain of the receiving antenna divided by the path loss. Same equation we have to represent in decibel. So Pr is equal to EIRP plus GR minus LP. The square bracket indicates the quantities are in a decibel. So now we have to start the uplink design. So we are going to deal with the uplink design. So it includes the power generation at the earth station, various power gains, that is the gain of the receiving antenna, gain of the transmitting antenna, and losses associated with the signal traveling in the upper direction. So now let us see the diagram, block diagram of the uplink power budget. So look at this diagram here. Uplink means signal is transmitted from a station in the upper direction towards the satellite. So here three, four components are here. First is your high power amplifier. Second one is a earth station antenna. Third one is your satellite antenna and the satellite receiver. So in between this is the distance, that is R is the distance between a earth station and the satellite. Now look at here, what is the role of this HPA? HPA stands for high power amplifier. The purpose of this high power amplifier is to supply the power which is to be radiated in all direction and it is received at the receiving antenna. Okay, now that is the HPA, that is power is generated at the earth station and it is amplified and it is radiated towards the satellite. So when the power is radiated towards the satellite, some of the power is wasted at the earth station and that loss is called as the transmitter feeder loss. It is indicated by a letter TFL. And now one more loss we are getting here, that is antenna mismatch loss, that is a misalignment of antenna. If antenna is not properly aligned, so we'll get a loss and that loss is called as a antenna mismatch loss. Okay, look at here, that is GES. GES means what? Gain of the earth station antenna. So the signal is transmitted from the earth station to the satellite. At that time, many losses are occur in the link. The first loss is a transmitter feeder loss. Second loss is an antenna mismatch loss. It is denoted by letter AML. And third loss is a polarization loss. It is indicated by letter PLU. And one more loss is here, that is the atmospheric absorption loss. It is due to the rainy season. Due to the rain, we are getting a loss in the signal. So that loss is the atmospheric absorption loss in the uplink. It is denoted by letter AA. And one more loss is there, that is a receiver feeder loss at the satellite. Similar way here, power is received at the receiver by the receiving antenna. But some of the power is wasted here. And that loss is called as a receiver feeder loss, indicated by letter RFL. Now here that is GSAT. GSAT means what? That is gain of the satellite antenna. Now we have to see the equation for transmitting power. One more loss is arise in between the link, that is a free space loss. So now we have to see the equation for transmitting power from the earth station. So this is the equation, that is effective isotropic radiated power by the earth station is nothing but power of the high power amplifier plus gain of the earth station antenna GES minus transmitter feeder loss TFL. So U indicates here, that is subscript U indicates here uplink and square bracket indicates that quantities are expressed in a decibel. So EIRP, effective isotropic radiated power in decibel, TFL, transmit feeder loss, GES, gain of the station antenna, PA, higher power at the output of the power amplifier. When the power is transmitted on the uplink, it comes across the various losses before it reaches to the satellite. And these losses are called as the transmission path loss. So first loss is the antenna misalignment loss, polarization loss second, third one is the atmospheric absorption loss, fourth is your free space loss in the uplink, one more loss is there, that is a receiver feeder loss. Addition of all these losses is nothing but the transmission path loss and it is indicated by equation number 2. So let us, here we are going to discuss the equation for received power by the satellite receiver. So it is expressed as transmitted power EIRP minus transmitter feeder loss is nothing but your transmission path loss, that is a total loss available in the link, plus GSAT, gain of the satellite receiver, minus RFL, receiver feeder loss. This is equation number 3. In satellite transmission, we use a phase modulation for digital signal and frequency modulation for analog signal. The amplitude of the carrier signal is constant irrespective of the modulation technique used. Hence, the power of the signal at the satellite receiver is the power of the carrier. So it is, therefore it is C equal to PU. Now we have to calculate the noise power at the satellite receiver. The noise power of the satellite receiver is denoted by letter NU. NU is nothing but noise power. It is the product of the Boltzmann constant, noise temperature and noise bandwidth. That is a KTSAT-B. Okay. Now we have to calculate the carrier to noise ratio. Carrier to noise ratio for uplink is nothing but ratio of the carrier power to the noise power. So C by NU is equal to PU upon KTSAT-B. U. So we have to express this expression in decibel form. So it becomes C by NU minus PU minus KT sat B. So we have to substitute the value of PU here in this expression. So it becomes C by N equal to EIRP minus TPL plus GSAT minus RFA minus K minus PSAT minus B. So look at this equation. GSAT and TSAT, these quantities are expressed in a decibel. So we have to express this GSAT plus GSAT and minus TSAT in the form of G by T. So G by T is nothing but the figure of merit of satellite system. So then equation becomes here C by N equal to EIRP minus TPL minus RFL plus G by T sat minus K minus B. Now we have to calculate the carrier to noise power density ratio. So we are aware of the carrier power, but we are not aware of the noise power density. So noise spectral density is denoted by letter N0, and it is nothing but the ratio of noise power to the noise bandwidth, that is PN by B. So we know the PN is the noise power, KT sat B upon B. So N0 becomes KT sat. Substitute this value in the expression, it becomes C by N0 is equal to PU minus N0. Now here, substitute the value of PU in this expression, that is equation number 7. So it becomes EIRP minus TPL plus GSAT minus RFL minus KTSAT. Simplify this expression, it becomes EIRP minus TPL plus GSAT minus RFL minus K minus TSAT. Now look at this expression GSAT minus TSAT, we have to express in the form of G by TSAT. Then equation becomes EIRP minus TPL minus RFL minus K plus G by TSAT. So K is your Boltzmann constant. We know the value of Boltzmann constant, 1.35 into 10 raised to minus 23. So we have to express this value in decibel. It becomes minus 228.6 dB. Then expression becomes C by N0 is equal to EIRP minus TPL minus RFL plus G by TSAT minus of minus 228.6. So now our final expression becomes C by N0 equal to EIRP minus TPL minus RFL plus G by TSAT plus 228.6. This is the final expression for carrier to noise power density ratio. So now here, what are the steps involved in designing a uplink power budget? So get the uplink power budget. Our first step is what? Get the expression for equivalent isotropic radiated power in the uplink. And we know the expression for EIRP is equal to PT into GT. PT into GT plus GR minus TPL. The second step is what? Write down the expression for losses involved in the link. Our third step is what? Write down the expression for power received by the satellite receiver. So how can we write down this expression? Very simple. What are the losses are involved in the link? And what is our transmitting power? So subtract the losses from the transmitting power, you will get the received power. Then express our received power in the form of carrier to noise ratio. Then calculate the carrier to noise ratio, noise power density ratio. These are the steps you have to follow to get the uplink power budget. Now look at the, we are going to solve the problem based on the uplink design. And how can we identify this problem is based on uplink and downlink design? So see here, a C-band earth station has an antenna of transmitting gain of 54 dB. The transmitter power is set to 100 watt at a frequency of 6.1 gigahertz. The signal is received by the satellite at a distance of 37,500 km by an antenna with gain of 26 dB. The signal is then routed to transponder with noise temperature of 500 Kelvin, bandwidth of 36 megahertz and gain of 110 dB. Calculate a path loss at 6.1 gigahertz. Calculate power at power port or output port at satellite antenna in the dB band. Calculate noise power at the transponder port in the dB band in the bandwidth of 36 megahertz. Calculate the C-band ratio in the transponder. So it in the problem, it is strictly mentioned that power is transmitting from the earth station and it is received at the satellite transponder. So this problem is based on uplink power budget. So you have to follow the steps of uplink power budget. Our very first step is what? That is a calculate the EARP. Second step is write down the expression for path loss. Third step is what? Write down the expression for received power. Fourth step is what? Calculate the C-band ratio. Then final step is here. Calculate the C-band N0. That is a carrier to noise power density ratio. But in the problem, it is asked to calculate the path loss. So we have to calculate the path loss. So now look at here. F is equal to C-by 6.1 gigahertz. From the frequency, we have to calculate the lambda. That is lambda is equal to 0.04918 meter bandwidth. So power, equation for path loss is equal to 10 log 4 pi r lambda raised to 2. We know the r is a 37,500 kilometer. And from that, we got the value 199.6 dB. So uplink power budget is nothing but your EARP plus GR minus LP. So EARP is nothing but product of your transmitting power and the gain of the transmitting antenna. So gain of the transmitting antenna, it is mentioned here that is a 54 dB and that is a transmitting power. It is a 100 watt is mentioned. That value you have to convert in decibel. It becomes a 20. 20 plus 54 plus 26. It is a gain of the receiving antenna minus 199.6. This is nothing but your loss, path loss. Then it becomes a minus 99.6 dB received power. So noise power equation is your K plus T plus B. So substitute the value of this here. So you will get here minus 126 dB watt. Then from these two equation, we have to calculate the C band ratio. That is a P minus N. Equal to minus 99.6 minus of minus 126 is equal to 26.4 degree. This is a carrier to noise ratio. This is regarding the uplink design problem. Now look at here. This is the complete design procedure is given for satellite communication link. So it includes complete link, that is uplink as well as a downlink. So that is a earth station to satellite, satellite to earth station. So these are the steps to design a satellite communication link. So very first step is what? Determine the frequency band in which our link will operate. Second step is what? Comparative regions may be required to help the selection. The next step is what? Here we are using a satellite. So what are the communication parameter of satellite should be determined here and estimate the values. These are not known to us. Fourth step is what? Here we are using a two earth stations. So we should know the parameters of transmitting as well as receiving earth station. So now here we have to start our design from the first earth station, that is a transmitting earth station, and establish a uplink power budget. So we are just now we are familiar with the uplink power budget, the steps involved in the uplink power budget. So calculate the C by N ratio for uplink. Then calculate the C by N ratio for downlink design. So and then calculate the signal to noise ratio or bit error rate in the baseband channel. Find out the link margin. Then evaluate the results and compare with the specification requirement. If change will be required, then do the change and get the acceptable C band 0 or S band or bit error values, bit error rate values. This may require several trial designs. Then determine the propagation condition under which the link will operate. Calculate the outage time for the uplink as well as downlinks. And the final step is what? Redesign the system by changing the some parameters if the margin is not adequate. Check that all the parameters are reasonable and that design can be implemented with the expected with the expected budget. Thank you.